A breast cancer veteran. That's how a mom here in Columbus describes herself after years of battling and surviving a devastating disease. And she wants other women to know, especially women of color, that she is working every day to break down barriers and make a difference that spans the generations.
For Asha and Danny Miller, there is joy in the simple things, like a walk in the neighborhood. Because these steps forward are only possible after taking so many devastating steps back.
Just loving the person that I am today is, it's such a gift.
6 years ago, this healthy, happy, fit mom of two young children found a tiny lump under her arm, one that would eventually lead to a diagnosis, breast cancer.
And at that moment, I went numb.
And then she would learn it had spread
to my lymph nodes, and it was also against my chest wall, calcified, and it was just devastating.
Stage 3B. In the time that followed, there were many painful surgeries, including a double mastectomy, chemotherapy treatments, and radiation that caused third-degree burns.
The mental part of cancer is something that is not talked about enough. It's this bone-weary exhaustion. It's body, mind, and spirit.
Just when she thought it was over, her reconstructive implants were recalled and had to be removed.
That was the most devastating, because they said, we're gonna have to take those out and you're gonna have to heal flat. And not flat closure, but like a deflated chest.
It was hard. It was harrowing. It was heartbreaking.
For me, it was how do I learn to love myself when I look so different?
That question sparked a new journey into advocacy, hoping her own battle will inspire, empower, and save lives.
Black women are dying 40% more from breast cancer than our white counterparts, even though we are diagnosed at the same rate.
Alarming numbers and a reality about disparities in care and awareness that she's fighting to change.
It was very terrifying to go through it and not see anybody that looked like me.
In her determination to reach other women, she found the faith she needed in self-love and the grace of gratitude.
You're the kind of person that brings color to where you walk. You spark light in the gloom and vibrance in the black and white. Your color doesn't fade with splendor, doesn't bow to complacency and mediocrity. You shine like you were born to. You revel in the light, and you are beautiful. That confidence you wear is gorgeous. Keep walking around this world, and we will see a trail of your fantastic colors as you go.
But the power and the impact of words truly hit home when she looked at her daughter.
What I say to myself, she's also going to say to herself. What I say out loud, she might think to herself. How do I say that I'm not beautiful with a flat chest when she's standing there at 7 years old as a flat, you know, with a flat chest?
And so the pages of her storyline turned into a family affair.
Now my daughter identifies as a previvor, which means that you have a genetic predisposition to get cancer.
Being a previvor, instead of being scared and worried about being it, you're very empowered, I feel like.
Together, mom, daughter, and Asha's now teenage son use social media to spread the word and share their mission.
Some of them are kind of like funny and geeky, and some of them are very meaningful.
Like Feel It on the First, a monthly reminder about the importance of self-exams. Their message, so authentic and powerful, a national campaign came calling. Asha was asked to pose for Victoria's Secret as the company's first black breastless model.
For me, representation matters, and I'll say that over and over. It really does in every aspect.
The pictures.
Love you.
The videos.
Love you, babe.
The celebrations, big and small.
I did it right!
Are just some of the many incredible moments in a life where she takes nothing for granted.
It isn't over. It's never over. It's a lifelong diagnosis. And yet we're here and we're thriving in the midst of it. And I think that for me is the most beautiful thing.
It's the sound of hope, the whizzing of a sewing machine. But it's what these women are crafting that's so meaningful. Every stitch is a stitch of love.
It changes their lives many times.
The lives they're changing? Cancer patients.
We make free headwear for men, women, and children, and we make all these styles that you see.
The Turban Project started about 10 years ago.
I was working with a girl that was undergoing breast cancer, and she had lost her hair.
Kathy Bradick wanted to make one for a coworker.
I didn't sew, and so this is a God thing. So out of my mouth comes, would you like me to make you some turbans?
And she hasn't stopped making these turbans. What started out as a few now blossomed into this. A team of what Kathy calls angels, helping her with her mission, like Marsha Mikeworth.
I have many family members that had cancer.
And just last year, she lost her sister to breast cancer.
When they lose their hair, sometimes they lose their dignity.
She says the turbans help them regain their self-esteem, so they sow seeds of hope. So far, they've given away nearly 200,000 turbans, courage caps, and beanies.
Now we're in every state and 14 countries.
Ashley Ellison comforted every time she puts one on.
Initially, I thought, oh, maybe I won't lose my hair. You know, maybe I'll be like, I'll be special or have a superpower and keep it.
The young mother of two diagnosed with breast cancer in January.
You're in shock at first, and you think, oh gosh, it can't be me. You know, this can't be real. And then you just kind of feel alone.
But she's not. Every time she wears her turban, she's reminded.
It makes me feel thought of. It makes you feel like you're supported.
Before each turban arrives, they're prayed over, and each receives a little bling.
All the turbans go out with jewelry on them.
It's that little extra touch.
Whoever gets it, it will bring them joy.
That makes each so special.
She's very sad, so we need something bright.
Each patient receives 5 or 6 turbans at a time. Some even request certain patterns.
We really try to make them smile. 100% free. If we mail them, we pay shipping. Zero cost for a patient.
All of the material, everything you see here, is donated. And while they can't take away someone's cancer.
Likes to fish, and they ask for a courage cap, which is cotton and it ties behind the head.
They can still bring comfort and care.
I never realized, I never realized the difference you can make in a person's life by doing something small.
Warming the hearts and heads of everyone who wears one.